Nationally, and some regions shows a slowing down in increase in the number of cases. However, the national case classification and health systems capacity remain to be at high risk. Majority or 95% of provinces, highly urbanized cities, and independent component cities remains to be flagged under alert levels 3 and alert level 4. More than half of the regions still with high risk health systems capacity, and majority, about 82% of flagged areas, have high risk health systems capacity. Cases may still continue to increase in the next weeks due to higher transmissibility of the Delta variant of concern, and as we continue active case finding in our areas. So we should implement strict granular lockdowns. We should shorten the interval between detection and isolation, and we should enforce the compliance to minimum public health standards to cut community transmission. We should also strengthen our triage and referral systems and be able to augment healthcare capacity to safeguard healthcare capacity. And lastly, we have to ramp up priority vaccination to protect the vulnerable population. Next slide. Next slide. So of the 11,132 sample sequenced assigned with a lineage as of August 27, 24% of samples were positive for the beta variant, 21.5% were positive for the alpha variant, and 16% were positive for the delta variant. 0.02% were samples positive for the gamma variant. Next slide. Among all the sequenced samples in the Philippines, 62% of the 11,132 samples with assigned lineages positive for the alpha, beta, or delta variant. All regions either have an alpha or a beta variant, while 16 regions have delta variant cases. All NCR cities were found to have a variant of concern, as well as 513 or 61% of the returning overseas Filipinos. Next slide. As of September 5, 2021, the total reported confirmed cases is 2,080,984, of which 7.57% are active cases, 90.79% are recoveries, and 1.65% are deaths. Looking more closely at our active cases, 97.91% of these are either asymptomatic, mild or moderate cases, and 2.09% or 3,292 cases are severe or critical. For September 5, the top 5 regions contributing to the new cases being reported are the National Capital Region, regions 4A, 3, 1, and 7. The top 5 areas contributing to the new cases are Cavite, Laguna, Rizal, Quezon City, and Bulacan. Next slide. Confirmed cases shows a steep increase and has exceeded the 7-day moving average. Our epidemic curve shows a new peak every week since the second week of August. Cases from August 30 to September 5 recorded 18,292 cases per day, an increase of 1,779 or 11% cases per day compared to the previous week of August 23 to 29, which was at 16,513 cases. As the cases increased, the National Capital Region, the dark blue bars, Region 7, the orange bars, Region 4A, the teal bars, and Region 3, the yellow bars, and Region 6, the violet bars, continue to show increase in proportion. Next slide. Disaggregating our epidemic curve into the major island groups and the NCR plus, we have noted that all areas are showing an increase in the number of cases. NCR and plus areas, the dark blue and the green lines, as well as the rest of Luzon, which is the red line, are showing a steep increase. Visayas at a plateau, while Mindanao exhibiting continued increase in cases. Next slide. Nationally, we remain to be at high-risk case classification with a positive 2-week growth rate at 32% and a high-risk average daily attack rate, which increased to 15.79 cases for every 100,000 population. A decrease in the two-week growth rate is seen nationally and in seven regions, which are the NCR, regions 4A, 3, 10, 1, and 7. Region 7 now has a negative two-week growth rate. The national ICU utilization rate remains to be at high risk. 9 regions have high-risk health systems capacity. We would like to flag the National Capital Region, regions 4A, 2, CAR, 3, 10, 1, 11, Caraga, 6, and 12 with high-risk case classification based on its moderate risk two-week growth rate and high-risk average daily attack rate. The NCR maintains positive two-week growth rate and a high-risk average daily attack rate and is currently at high-risk case classification. A DAR increased from 25.61 in the previous 3 to 4 weeks to 33.60 per 100,000 population in the recent week.